Hi, my name's Leon. You might probably know me from the previous video that we recorded regarding CXX-Qt. If you haven't seen that yet, I highly recommend you check that out. And we've also released a blog post that you may not have read yet. So after releasing this blog post and that video, we also received a lot of questions about CXX-Qt. Which is why today I'm here with Andrew, who's the main developer of CXX-Qt here at KDAB, to answer some of your most frequently asked questions. But before we do that, let's talk a bit about the background of CXX-Qt and Rust-Qt bindings in general. So, Andrew, what are the most common Rust bindings for Qt?
There are three common bindings for Rust and Qt currently. There's the qmetaobject-rs, the Rust-Qt binding generator, and the ritual bindings. qmetaobject-rs uses CPP crate and embeds C++ within their Rust code and uses some macro expansion to make the developer's code easier. The Rust Qt binding generator uses the CC crate and requires a JSON description of the bridge between the Rust and Qt sides. And the ritual bindings are similar to bindgen and automatically generate a list of methods and functions from the Qt API, which tend to be unsafe. So, Leon, when would we use each of these?
So we can basically divide these bindings into several categories. First are the direct or unsafe bindings and or bindings that expose large amounts of the Qt API, typically in an automated fashion. These allow you to get access to basically all of Qt's functionality, but they can often be very alien from a Rust perspective and often also need to be wrapped in unsafe blocks or otherwise are difficult to interact with from a Rust perspective. Then there also exist wrapped bindings, which is, for example, qmetaobject-rs, that allow you to write code that's less directly on top of Qt, but at a higher level of abstraction in the Rust code. And in the example of qmetaobject-rs, this also changes how you integrate your code with Qt. With the other bindings, you actually call Qt from Rust. With qmetaobject-rs, you can simply expose Rust functionality to Qt. That then brings us to the first most frequently asked questions. Andrew, why then would one go and develop a new Rust binding for Qt like you have done with CXX-Qt?
We want to bring Rust to Qt in a similar way to qmetaobject-rs, but there are new features available since other attempts have been made, such as CXX is a new crate for bridging between C++ code and Rust code in a safe and idiomatic way. And there's been an expansion in the support of procedural macros, which allow us to provide a richer API on the Rust side than could previously be possible.
Also, in my experience with CXX-Qt, CXX-Qt also allows us to really reduce the amount of unsafe code and also increases the maintainability of the code by a lot. For example, with Qt version check, that's something that qmetaobject-rs had to do quite a lot because they directly call C++ code, but we really don't. And also we, by using CXX, can get a much more idiomatic API on the Rust side, but also on the C++ side, as you probably saw in the previously released video on CXX-Qt that we did. And also from what I've gathered from talking to you is that really an important point is to limit the scope of CXX-Qt, right? So that it can be more opinionated than some of the other bindings. And that way, some of the details from the Qt API can be removed on the Rust side so that it's much more idiomatic on the Rust side and feels more at home there, right?
Right.
So where do you, as the lead developer of CXX-Qt, think that Rust is most valuable when added to a Qt application?
We feel that Rust is most useful in the backend code or the business logic of an application. As we discussed in our other videos and the blog, Rust has a guarantees from memory safety and is very performant. So it's very good at handling large amounts of data asynchronously and in multi-threads and things like that. So it's very useful for the business layer. However, we believe that C++ and especially QML are still very valuable in a Qt application. And we feel that it's useful to still be able to link to the existing C++ ecosystem of code. So, Leon, is C++ knowledge still required to use CXX-Qt?
Yes, for CXX-Qt, you will need at least basic C++ knowledge because it also integrates into the existing C++ build tools like CMake. And we also just believe that if you are using Qt, there's probably no way to really get around C++ easily. So, Andrew, another question we often received was, what features do we want to develop in the future with CXX-Qt?
In the future, we'd like to develop support for more Qt-based classes and other types, such as idiomatic list models. And we'd like to integrate further with other Rust libraries and further with CXX, allowing you to express your own CXX bridges within our application. And we are looking for feedback for features or requests on GitHub. Thanks for watching our FAQ on Rust bindings for Qt. We will be attending Qt DevCon and Embedded World in June, where we'll be doing a presentation at Qt DevCon and we'll be at the Qt booth at Embedded World. Have a look in the description below for more information and links. If you have any questions or comments, please write them below the video. We'll be happy to answer them. And we'll see you in the next video. Bye.